Why don't we ever get rooms of our own? Mary demanded crossly. William always does, just because he's a boy. It isn't fair.
I don't mind sharing with you, Mare, Alice said in a small voice.
That's not the point. I mind sharing with you. I want a room to myself.
It's ever such a big house, Mare, Alice whispered, her eyes wide as she looked round at all the dark corners on the landing outside their door.
You're such a wimp, Alice, Mary said, and then she screamed and dived for her bed as William jumped out of his room with a snarl. William, I'll kill you if you do that again. I swear I will.
Don't, Will, Alice said, still using her small voice. I don't like it here.
William put an arm around her and hugged her. It's all right, Al. I'll be next door, and Uncle Jack's just downstairs.
But what if a witch comes in the night? Mary whispered, warming to her subject. You wouldn't hear us if she put a spell on us straight away. She could take us off into one of the other rooms where Uncle Jack hasn't even been yet, and she could lock us away and make us sleep forever, and no one would even know where to look for us.
Alice sat on the edge of her bed, wide-eyed and hugging herself. As Mary finished speaking, she suddenly leaped across the room, wailing and waving her hands in front of her. Alice shot back up the bed and pulled the eiderdown over her head. "Mary," William said, using his big brother voice, "you're scaring Alice."
"No, she isn't. I think she's stupid," Alice said, her head still under the eiderdown.
"And the witch would come each day and fatten you up," Mary continued, kneeling on the bed in front of the crouched figure under the eiderdown. "And she'd come and prod you every so often to see if you were ready to eat."
As she shouted the word eat, her hands dived under the eiderdown and she started to tickle her sister.
"Oh, stop it, Mary, stop it," Alice pleaded, shrieking and giggling helplessly at the same time.
"Mary, I'm warning you," William said, and he dived on top of her, pulling her off Alice. This unexpected onslaught knocked Mary off balance and she started to topple off the bed. Grabbing Alice, she tried to steady herself. But instead, all three of them landed on the floor with a bump and lay there panting and exhausted.
"Oh, I feel sick now," Alice groaned, and she started to laugh again.
"Hey, you lot," they heard Jack calling up the staircase from the gallery below. "Supper!"
"Ooh, supper! I'll be sick," Alice moaned.
Then she got to her feet and ran for the door.
"Mary doesn't want any supper, Uncle Jack. She's lying down," she yelled.
"You liar, Alice," Mary said, scrambling to her feet, just as Jack came into the room.
"What's going on?" he asked anxiously. "Are you ill?"
"Take no notice of them," William confided in him. "They're all right, really."
"She was lying down," Alice said.